Husain Money, you know what I mean? Germantown, Philadelphia, you know what I'm saying? Philly, y'all know me, man. You know what I mean? I've been doing this forever, man. Like since 98 or something like that. Yeah, so yeah, man, that's me, man.
What's up, Joe Sabi, boy Stunna, El Del Flav, rapping Philly since 99.
Drew Bonnie.
Yo, you. Andrew Ramsey, Ride the Virus, RTV. Been breaking seriously since 05. I rep El Del Flav, been rapping El Del Flav since 04.
When you start dancing?
Oh, I started dancing.
You gotta say that they gonna think you, you know what I mean, 2005. Like, nah, you
been, man, I've been a dancer since I've been a dancer
for like a long time.
I've been a dancer since 6 years old, dancing Michael Jackson, pop and lock. Oh, what I thought was pop and lock.
All right.
Well, basically, I don't know. You put me on to the first shit that I seen for breaking wise, like face to face, like live in action was. This guy right here, Adrian, Corey, Disco Dan, Raul, Alberto, Spit, Down Rock, Rap. I didn't see Rap so much until later. All the names I just named, I seen in the club. Also, like, on some B-boy shit. I didn't see Rap until, I didn't really see Rap dance at all. Until, like, he wanted me to join Olive and shit. And, you know, just getting his skills sharp. So I guess like the names I just put out pretty much put me on my first influence of B-boy, Philly wise at least.
Same.
Me, I get down with a lot of them names. Those are some of the first people I seen really break. You know what I mean? I went to high school with Flip, so we was in the same school. He used to break. So you know what I mean, I was like, yeah, I know how to do that, whatever. So I mean, we just started breaking from then on. You know what I mean? Then we started going to Kumquat, and it was Rap. It was really Rap, really, you know what I mean? Who I really started practicing with, who really put me on some stuff, you know what I mean? Between him and Cricket. Cricket wasn't around so much, but Cricket get credit too. But definitely Rap, you know what I mean? Also other people, but like Rap.
Same thing. You know, Adrian, actually, it was me and my boy Mark Epic. We went to school together. And there was this game we was playing called Bust a Move or Bust a Groove or something like that. There was a dude on the name Heat. And he started like breaking and doing windmills. And then kind of like, we were surprised because we hadn't seen breaking on a video game like that. And so like instantly like it kind of reminded us of like the stuff we started watching. We was watching these littler like breaking two, you know, the like, V Street. And we started watching those videos and actually really like, it was more or less of a group of people that really kind of like inspired me to like get into it, like Husain, Flitz, Jacob.
Peace to Jacob.
Yeah, peace to Jacob. Those were really the main people. And Cricket. There was also other people that were around when I was breaking, like a crew from Cherry Hill called ECT or something like that. I think that's what their name was. But, that's basically where all my influences came from, actually wanting to be involved with the scene. To be actually an active patron of the scene as far as like actually doing stuff and trying to practice add my two cents into the whole thing, women things. Didn't really happen until I got with Chosen Dance Company under the direction of Clyde Evans. That's when he really showed me that this was more than just having fun, or it could be more than just having fun. And if you take it serious, you know, the rewards are just as serious.
Yeah, definitely Clyde Evans. He put us on some stuff too, you know what I mean? You can't forget about him. You know what I mean? He opened us up to, like, you know what I mean? More than just, you know what I mean? How to get money dancing, you know what I mean? Not just, you know what I mean, moves or practice or whatever, but like, actually, you know what I mean? How to be professional, you know what I mean? Like, doing the job or whatever. You know what I mean? That's why, right there.
He basically showed us how to make what we love to do keep us alive.
Cloud was actually the first person that kind of exposed me to the dancing aspect of breaking. When I started breaking, I didn't look at it as a dance. I just looked at it as some shit like you just went off and just did your thing. So coming from the club too. I never was at a jam. I never went to practices like that. I was just always in the club. So once we started messing with Clyde, that kind of put me on to like, I don't know how to dance and apply that to like breaking and shit like that. So.
How you think it's going downhill?
It's too easy, man.
Yeah, it's too easy. I mean, you got a lot of people, you know what I mean, getting over just on doing blogs. That's been happening for a minute, but like, you got too many people getting over, like, you know what I mean, not even dancing, you know what I mean, doing little blogs, doing little sets and combinations or whatever. It's called breaking for a reason. You're supposed to break. I mean, you're supposed to write everything down, you know what I mean? And you can see it, like, anybody who's been in the game long enough that's a real people, you can see it right away when somebody, you know what I mean, throwing down a set or they don't really got it, like, and I'm seeing a lot of that these days, you know what I mean? And it's just like, it kind of made me, like, fall back from the scene a little bit, because it was just so much of that going on. It's just like, whatever, man. Like,
he was talking about the whole, like, the lack of creativity, you know, like, I mean, back when we started, you know what I'm saying, there was no internet, there was no YouTube and shit, so that in itself made it more difficult, because if you went to a jam and you saw something, I was like, yo, that shit was hot, I'm gonna try something like that, you can't click and be like, I'm gonna take it back to 2 minutes and 30 seconds and watch that shit 50 times over until I get it right. It was like, it didn't go off the top of the dome, so eventually you was gonna make your own shit anyway out of some type of inspiration. It wasn't straight biting and taking somebody's move. And then he's saying now cats is straight taking people's swag, their character. And like, that defeats the whole purpose of breaking in hip hop to begin with. You gotta be yourself, you know what I mean? A lot of people is fronting, so.
I'm just wondering like how come niggas ain't dancing no more, because I mean, like, when I first started breaking, like, I was dancing to get the girls.
Cats is dancing, but they going that corny little house dancing.
Nah, that's not what I mean. Like, it's part of the scenes.
They going that little corny
like,
house dancing, just because it's all, like, nah, no disrespect to house, but they going, like, these little house dance, pitter-patter, you know what I'm saying? Like, just because it's on beat, like, it's thorough.
Breaking for me, when as far back as I can remember, when I first started, and the reason why I fell in love with it is because it was a soul revival. Like, there were certain things going on in my life, and then I felt kind of caged up. So when I was introduced to breaking, I kind of felt like I had a reason to express myself, like I was in church, you know what I mean? So I guess you could say catching the Holy Ghost, you know what I mean? A lot of people back in the day used to catch the Holy Ghost and would just go off of that, because that's exactly what it was. Nowadays, cats are just sitting around and like, trying to imitate the Holy Ghost. You know what I'm saying? It's like, how you gonna imitate something that should be supposed to be so natural? That's
right,
why a lot
right,
of people
right,
is at
right,
jams
right,
now
right.
Sitting around watching people because they don't even know how to have that feeling anymore because they're so caught up in going from this move, da da da. It's like, yo, there is a DJ playing music. Just fucking dance. You know what I mean? I mean, practice is something totally different. You're supposed to do that. Just make sure you stay on top of your shit. But when it comes down to the jams and the circles that actually sharing with one another, people. Shit's gone.
What I don't like about the scene and what I do like about the scene, I'm gonna start at home first because.
I'm talking about at home, by the way.
Huh?
I'm talking about at home.
Well, yeah, that's jump on home. What y'all like and don't like about the scene home right now?
At home, cats ain't breaking like Philly cats no more, man.
Yes.
Everybody wanna look like so-and-so from over there, over here.
Yeah.
But that defeats the whole purpose of being from where you're from.
Ben break
like Philly cat. Straight up break from the heart. That's the whole point. Philly never came up
on that ass.
Some technique shit, like, this is how you do it. We just went off the top. What we was feeling at the time. So, you know, to me, I feel like Philly is one of the truest cities because we just straight break. You know what I mean? At least coming up, things is a lot different now. I just remember coming up, the cats was just straight breaking.
You know what I mean? Like he was saying earlier, it's kind of like the internet is kind of poisoning the scene. Like, you know what I mean? Instead of cats really getting down with like their old heads or whatever, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? Vibing with their old heads, you know what I mean? Like, they getting influence from their old heads. They
back,
get straight. You know what I mean? Going on YouTube, you know what I mean? Biting this ball, you know what I mean? It's wet, and it shows, man. And it's like, you know what I mean? Like, we got a style down here, so it's like, you know what I mean? When you see somebody fraud, and it's just like, I mean, what is that?
Drew, what you feel?
I feel like, motherfuckers is
thing I don't like about the fucking scene is that back in the day when we was like coming up and shit, when I was coming up, like there's so much raw energy, like at like let's say for instance the gathering, like there was so much competitiveness in it, and it wasn't the fact that niggas was trying to go move for move, but it was the fact that people were trying to take the feeling to another level. And when you took a feeling to another level, the whole room, it made everybody better, you know what I'm saying? It made everybody want to step outside the box and do certain things that their body, that they didn't know their body could do. And like now, it's just like I said in the beginning, like, niggas is just, I mean, Philly as a city, it's so much soul, yo, so much funk. Like, it's almost like we harbor the funk and we understand the funk. And everybody else just forgets about the funk. Like the funk is the driving force for everything. And like when you take that out of anything that's supposed to be funky, it's just fuck. You know what I mean?
If you was just trying to inspire somebody, you was just trying to get a young boy straight, and they just had like a lot of potential to me is just like a lot of forks in a road. Yeah, I mean you could go either way. All the way is crazy, but yeah, I mean you know as well as I know, one straight path is the best way. Not confused about nothing. So if you were to tell somebody something to get them on that one straight path, what would you say? Yeah, I mean like what would like your motto be right now?
My motto, I got a couple of them, but I'll just give you two. You gotta get the first one before you can get to the second one. First joint is every road has bumps, no matter what you get into, whether it be dancing, picking up trash for a living. You're always gonna have good times, you're always gonna have hard times. But if you strive and believe in 100% what it is you're trying to do and you stay true to it, all the way through, you'll reach a goal. And applying that to like breaking or dancing anything, basically do it and don't bullshit through it.
That was mad eloquent.
No, me, like, all I say, yo, is just go for the jugular every time.
Go for the jugular.
That's it. Like, I mean, if you got that kind of mentality, yo, it don't really matter. Like, you don't have to be the best b-boy in the world, but if you got that mentality, Mugs, cats is going to respect you, you know what I mean, regardless, because, you know what I mean, that's what breaking is, really. A lot of cats forgot that, you know what I mean? Go for the jugular, man.
I mean, I think those things both come in hand with b-boying, in a sense. It's the truest thing I can tell somebody is just always be yourself. Always stay true to who you are. And don't ever forget who you are, because that's what you reflect when you dance and you break. That's the only thing you got is yourself. So don't ever fake the funk. Keep it real with yourself. And everything else is going to be cool.
Who on the scene right now doing anything?
Philly-wise, my nigga Hannibal.
Hannibal, definitely, you know what I'm saying?
My nigga, my
Josh.
Yeah. Josh, yeah.
Ben, of course. Flav, that's a given, you know what I'm saying?
Who Flav? You gotta say who Flav is.
But like,
you got some international figures in Flav. You gotta say who Flav is.
LL Flav, you got this guy, Husain Money, you got Riot the Virus, you got Joe Stunna, you got some other cats that's international right now, you got Seth Cuts, you got
Epic Flav,
you got Epic Flav, and you got Flitz over in Cali, Evolve, Crafty, you still stuck in Jersey, get your ass out the house. Who else, man?
I mean, he's the Josh too, dog. He's one of the best dancers down here, dog. He's the JPZ, man.
He's the
best dancers out this mug, I mean. Bring it to you in any style, like, that's that bull.